Hi and welcome back to the Event Lighting channel. This time we're going to talk about GrandMA3 and FTP. And if you don't know what FTP is, I think it's something about file transfer protocol or something. And it's basically the ability to establish a connection between your computer and your GrandMA3 console or whatever you use as a GrandMA3, what kind of a board you're using. You can go into the hard drive via the FTP client, and you can take, for instance, you can take all your shows and copy them into your computer so they are safe. If you, for instance, want to rent your console to someone and you want to make sure that all the show data you have in there is kept safe, this is one way or one use case where you can use it. Another one would be if you have a software problem at some point and you want to reinstall your console and delete everything on the console to like format the hard drive, you want to FTP into the console first, take all the data you need out of the console, and then you can reinstall it and put it back in. It's not hard to do, it's quite simple actually. It only needs an FTP client on your computer and it needs a connection between the console and the computer. If you have used GrandMA3 on PC and a GrandMA3 console in the same session and it works, then you have the connection established and everything is fine. The only thing you need then is the FTP client. And I'm just going to show you how you get the FTP client. You go into Google and you search for FileZilla, like this. What did I write here? FileZilla. And the first pop up here, the FileZillaProject.org. You go into that one and you want to download the FileZilla client and not the FileZilla server. So we go in here and we say we want to download it for our system. Of course, you can get it for Mac and Linux as well, but we just want it for PC in this case. So it has four options here and most of them are paid. The first one here is free, so we'll just take that one and we'll save it into our download folder. And that's all we need to do. And now we just need to install it to make sure it's installed on our computer. So we say close to this one and we close this stuff here. And we open our download folder. You can see here it's ready for installation. So we just double click it and install it, and it should install on our computer now. And when it's done, we'll resume. The installation is now finished, and you can see this FileZilla client up here. We can open that one up, and this is basically FileZilla. We need a host, a username, a password, and a port to get into GrandMA3, and it's very, very simple to do. We just open up GrandMA3 and go into our network settings here. And if we are connected in a network like I am right now, I want to connect to my GrandMA3 Lite, which has the IP address of 192.168.10.3. So this is basically all I need to know from in here. So we can close this down and we can say 192.168.10.3. And there we are prompted for a username and a password and a port. The username accessing GrandMA3 is always the same. It's MA data, and the password is MA data as well. And then the port is 22, and this should be enough for us to connect to GrandMA3. So we say quick connect. It's gonna warn us because the computer doesn't really know what it's accessing, but we think it's okay. So now you can see we are now connected into our GrandMA3 Lite. And this is basically what's happening on the hard drive. You can see some different software versions here. And I am working in 1.9.7. And you can see it opened up down here with a lot of different folders. I want to get into the shared folder. I want to get into the show folder. And this is basically all the shows that are currently on my hard drive in GrandMA3. You also have backups here if you want to take all your backups out. In my case, I just want to take all my shows, which is fine. So I just create a new folder here in my desktop. And basically this is ready to go. So I just mark one show here. I say Control A, which is everything. And now I just drag everything into this folder and drop it here. And you can see it's starting to work now and transferring show by show into this folder. It's not going to take very long. You can see it done now. 41 successful transfers, and I can open the folder now, and here is all my show information, all the shows that I had on my hard drive. Another thing you can access if you are working with recipes and MVRs and stuff like that, you can also access your MVR information in your console like this. And if you want to do that, you can go into GrandMA3 library. You get all kinds of different stuff in here if you want to add the fixture profiles and stuff like that. And if you want to add some MVR information, which is always supposed to be accessible on your console, you can put it in here. You can also just have it on in your show folder on your USB. That's also fine. But go in here, dump your MVR info, and it's going to be available on your console for all the shows you do. So this is GrandMA3 and the way you access GrandMA3. Let's just have a look at the file system for GrandMA2 as well, because many people use their GrandMA3 console in MA2 mode, and I just want to show you how you access that. And the only difference is if you go up here into the connection, instead of MA data in the password and username, or username and password, we just say data and data, and then the port is still 22, and we try to connect to that, and we say abort the previous one and connect to the new one. And you can see here the file structure has now changed. It's version 1.9.60, which is an MA2, the latest streaming version for GrandMA2, and you can access that and go into a folder here. And once again, you can go in and take all your shows out and put shows in or whatever you want to do. One thing about accessing your hard drive with FTP is, as a rule of thumb, don't touch anything you don't know what is. If you know you were going to work with shows and MVR, that's fine, but don't delete any folders or anything, because that will mess up the file system on your console. So you can use this, it's a great way of using it, but it's also dangerous if you don't know what you're doing. So just be careful with that. So this is how you work with the FTP and you log into your console and log out again, even in GrandMA2 mode. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, give it a like and a thumbs up. And if you are new to the channel and not subscribed yet, make sure you subscribe and click the little bell notification. That's going to give you a heads up every time I upload a new video. And until I see you next time in my next video, I hope you have some happy GrandMA3 programming at home, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.